Everybody, I'm Connor with Honor. The fat loss headlines, they're all over the place. I'm going to give you the top 10. They're going to talk about the best ways to lose weight, but more than likely, most of these are tricks. So watch out for them. So the first one, the number one that pops in, is the videos that are giving you a particular amount of days followed by the words fat loss transformation. So they're telling you that in 10 or 15 days, you're going to lose all your fat. Realistically, folks, even if you go into a really strict water fast, more than likely a pound a day, if that much, that's about going to be the maximum. That's typically what I've seen from myself and from other people that I've been training and talking to with regard to real estate. I dropped 135 pounds of body fat, and it really did. Some of the best days for fat loss, for once you get into the fasting and you start doing it regularly, you'll actually be able to figure out what your fat loss rate is. At the very beginning of any fasting routine, most of that weight loss is water. It's not fat. So you want to look for the fat loss. And about the best I could do was close to a pound a day. But it just depended on the length of time of the fast, what I was drinking, how I was walking, how I was working out. There's a lot to do. But watch out for those if they're promising you particular weight loss, especially if it's too good to be true. And also, you want to make sure that that weight is fat, not muscle. Number two, lose weight without exercise. Don't need to say much more. Abs come in the kitchen. You've heard this. Abdominal muscles, be able to have them revealed. You have to not eat as much. You have to be leaner in physique. And to get leaner in physique, you have to drop that adipose tissue, which is body fat. Number three, foods to never eat for fat loss. Again, that's a nice video title, but again, the foods that you would never eat if you really want to have optimum fat loss more than likely are going to be in the sugar category. Watch out for that. The alcohol, if that's a food group, I don't believe it is. But again, that would be something to stay away from. But really, as far as foods go, stay away from the stuff that makes you weak. Stay away from the stuff that drives you crazy and that you can't live without. Those are the things that you want to stay away from, because pushing yourself away from things you really want actually builds character and makes you stronger when the fasting comes and gives you better control over your life. So the next one, number four, an X minute workout for maximum fat burn. They're talking about HIIT training, high interval, high intensity training, HIIT training. They're talking about long, slow cardio, maybe at some times. Other people are going to be talking about burning muscle. It's a lot. It's your fasting setup. Talk to your doctor. Make sure this is okay for you to do. Start practicing the fasting regimen. And as far as the workout goes, my personal best, just walk. Get out there and walk. Don't count your steps on a step counter as your normal operational procedure throughout the day. You need to go out and make a committed walk. Go somewhere or get on a treadmill, but make a committed time frame other than the general walking you do throughout the day. People believe that they're normal walking. They look at their little meters. It's great, but is getting your steps in needs to be a sole and separate activity? I think it makes me feel good when I do it that way. If I try to make the workout an all-day deal, not a focus session, it just doesn't work as well. So that's something to consider. But again, if you're seeing these websites, a fast way to burn fat, we already talked about the number. That's really about the maximum you're going to be able to do. Number five, realistic fat loss routines for beginners. When you're a beginner, you lose stuff quickly, including fat. Your body hasn't been conditioned to resist at this particular point. But I don't know how many of us are beginners. I tried to drop my fat for a majority of my adult life. Finally, I got it together. But I got into my 50s before I realized how to do it. So I try to pass that on to you folks for nothing, so you can see, because fasting's free, right? The advice about it maybe should be too. All right, so then there's these stories about how I lost X amount of pounds in so many months. That's great. That's me, 135 pounds, about 7.5 months. Again, that was after I had practiced fasting for a time. So I knew how to honor the time that I spent refeeding, because that's the danger. You probably have the ability not to eat for a while. Maybe you can go a whole day. Maybe you're one of those that can go 2 or 3 days. Maybe you're really good at that, but maybe when you start to eat again, you gorge because you're so hungry. You don't relax into the next meal. You don't honor yourself by taking it gently, and you overdo it. That took a lot of practice for me because I'm a habitual eater. By habit, I eat for whatever reasons. I'm an emotional eater, and I have a very wide emotional footprint. So pretty much whatever emotional state I'm in, food was the driver. Food was the relaxer or the driver or the method. And I went to food all the time, and it was horrible. Finally got that under control. But if people are telling you they dropped this massive amount of weight in a time period, you need to do your research and find out what that is and is that safe. People talk about losing weight super fast. You don't want to do it. It's so dangerous. Talk to your doctor. I don't know. How much can you really lose, how fast, and what is required to be able to do a maximum fat burn? More than likely, total food cessation would probably be the way. So you're not eating at all. That would give you the maximum return. You want to look into that and see if that is beneficial to you. Look at what it does to your metabolism. Some people say it crashes it. That was the old word. Now they've done more fasting research. It looks like fasting actually increases metabolism. In fact, it increases it better in a way than caloric restriction, because with a caloric restricted diet, and again, do all your research, please, with your doctor. I'm not a nutritionist. This is the stuff I read. But from what I understand with caloric restriction, because you're not totally starving, totally not having food, your body can adjust itself to burn a certain amount of calories if that's what you happen to be eating. When you strip all the calories away and you're fasting, that's a whole different animal. Your body really, there's nothing it can do to settle for zero. So it's got to ramp up the metabolism to get your butt out there to hunt and get some food. But if you restrict your calories to a certain level, you can look at a lot of these shows with these really fat people that have torched off a lot of body weight. They're telling you that they've done this, and you give them, they've really done these really incredible feats. They've lost all this weight only to regain it all and more. Only to screw up their body percentages with fat versus muscle even more. So you have to be careful of those types of diets. This is a different animal with fasting, but look into it for yourself. All right, then you're going to see videos about fat loss myths debunked. This is one of those videos also, but look into that and see what they're talking about. They want you to sign up for their list, or they want you to, they're going to give you the top three things or the different body types or all these different. Understand you're going to be added to their mail list. They're going to be sending you a whole bunch of emails. They're going to get into their pipeline or their funnel, and then they're going to start really hitting you up and wanting, over time, they want you to spend money and pay for their product. Me, I sell houses. This is a side gig for me, but I do know how important it is. I like selling real estate, but this to me, trying to help people torch off their body fat because I was able to do it and I know how freeing it was, I want to pass that on to you. So there's that. X fat burning exercises you can do at home. So there's a lot moving, doing that extra movement. I have dumbbells here. I'll do Hindu squats standing here as I work. I stand up most of the day at my computer. In fact, almost all of it. So I'll be here 8, 10, 12 hours a day on my feet. That's comfortable for me, but it wasn't easy. It's taken months and months and months for me to be comfortable standing up. And when I stand up, I present, and I do a lot of standing throughout the day, and it does help. Number 9, complete guide to intermittent fasting. Yes, there's a lot to know about fasting, a lot to know how it affects your body, a lot to know if it's beneficial or not. So there's a lot for you to read up, but fasting itself requires no money. In fact, fasting itself doesn't require you to buy food, a particular type. It doesn't provide you to go to the supermarket and look at lists and look at ingredient labels. Fasting doesn't require, you to do anything except for nothing. Just don't eat. Of course, it's not simple. If it were simple, everybody would do it. If it were easy, we would all be skinny. Unfortunately, it doesn't work that way. You have to put in the work. You have to make the commitment. You have to make the decision. Nobody's going to make you do it. People can tell you all the day long, and you see it online, how easy, how piece of cake, how no problem, how it's going to be just like a walk in the woods. It's not easy, folks. The willpower required is not easy. The driver to keep you on the path to drop maximum body fat is not easy. Even minimum body fat is not easy. Dropping any fat isn't easy because your body is going to fight you. Your body doesn't want to lose it. You put it on over time. Maybe you put on 40 pounds in 10 years, but now that 40 pounds is hanging off the front of you. interrupting your entire goodwill and gesture to the world. You want to get rid of it. Look at the fasting. See how that works for you. And then look at the BS out there and stay away from it. If you have any questions, I'm Connor with Honor. Look me up. Ask me a question. No problem. You'll find me on all the social media you can imagine. Ask and I will reply. But I know you can do this. Anybody can do this. It isn't easy and it's very difficult, but I know you can. All right. So we did the fat burning exercises you can do at home. Here's number 9, complete guide to intermittent fasting. And again, it's free. Not a lot to know, but again, hit up your doctor. And then finally, the keto diet for beginners, a step-by-step guide. It's great. Keto is wonderful. Being that in that low-carb world is wonderful, but you have to see if that fits with your lifestyle, if that fits with you. I was going to talk about moderation a little bit earlier, about all these different foods like ice cream in moderation, pizza in moderation, alcohol in moderation, cigarettes in moderation, heroin in moderation. Wait a minute. So there are certain things you shouldn't even have in moderation then. So why does sugar get a pass? Why does alcohol get a pass? Why does most food get a pass, but heroin, that's not a once-in-a-time thing, or cocaine, or PCP, or any of these other hardcore drugs. But alcohol, sure, no problem, piece of cake. You should be able to handle that in moderation. I'll tell you a little bit about me, and maybe you're somewhat similar. I'm not good with moderation. I need strict rules in my life. If I'm allowed to do a lot of things, if I think that it's free will out there and I have no issues and there's no judgment and nobody's going to hate me for the decisions I make, not good for me. And also when it comes to food and alcohol and whatever, that's not good for me. Moderation doesn't work for me. I stay away from moderation. There are certain things I don't touch. I just won't eat them. Is it hard? Maybe at the beginning, if I really liked them. Alcohol wasn't easy to just let go. But I did, and now June 21st of last year, now we're in 2024. Yeah, I've been around it. I've seen other people drink it. It's been offered to me. It exists where I am. It's everywhere. I just don't touch it. I understand that everybody says just one isn't going to kill you, Connor. Yeah, might. One might actually do it because it doesn't stop with me with one. It goes to one and then five and then 10. And then I have a heartbeat as I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning, beating out of my chest, wondering what did I do last night? Not good. So again, moderation for me with alcohol isn't good. The same way moderation for me in ice cream and pizzas and cookies and cakes isn't good either. You got to make the decisions. I appreciate you watching. I'm Connor with Honor. When you're ready, reach out. I want to be there to help you the best I can. We'll talk to you soon. I'm Connor with Honor. Over and out.